Shabbat Shalom. Welcome to our B'nai Mitzvah, a milestone that I cannot believe that I've hit. It marks a turning point in my life, from an older, overindulgent child to a responsible young man. It signifies that I've changed over the course of my life, mostly for the better. In terms of my life, it indicates the end of an era filled with no responsibility and blissful ignorance. The miracles of childhood are over. I have to come to terms with my new responsibilities.
Ba'ohel mo'ed be'echad lehodesh hashini v'shana hashini letzeitam eretz mitzrayim lemor se'u et rosh kol adat b'nei Yisrael v'yishertu et kol kelai ohel mo'ed v'etz mitzmeret b'nei Yisrael la'avod et avodat hamishkan.
Good morning and Shabbat Shalom. Thank you all for coming. Now, let me set the scene. Lost, scared, stranded, and confused. Just like the Israelites, that's how I felt at the beginning of this experience. But what happened later? I slowly but surely composed myself, readying myself for this day. I want to thank everyone for just coming. Some live next door, others live across the country. I can't believe so many have come just to celebrate the existence of Nathaniel. And Shabbat Shalom.
I'm grateful for the curiosity both of you bring to your lives and to our lives. You teach yourselves about things that interest you, and then you teach us. It's a pretty special quality, and I want you to please always be curious about the world. And the number one thing I'm grateful for today is you two, Charles Alden, Nathaniel Grayson. Before you were born, I prayed to become a mother. And then God answered my prayer beyond my wildest imagination. I love you very much. I'm proud of your accomplishments. And I'm grateful beyond words to be your mother.
There are no two people I have met who have taught me more than you. No people I know who are so much their own guys. Forces for creativity, kindness, perception, curiosity. And you got a great way with a joke, as everybody could see. Because you knew instinctively a lesson that it took me years to learn, and that is, jokes and songs are the only way of understanding this bewildering world. From the dark tunnel, I saw a light of the train coming. A new light, but a very familiar light. And that light has illuminated and led my way ever since. Tell me where we're going, boys. I'll follow you.
Sure you guys would enjoy it.
Favorite destination is Rome. I love Italian food.
Hi, my favorite destination is Israel.
Hi, everybody. My favorite destination is where you are going to be because we love spending time with you.
So I've read a lot of books in my time, but if I had to recommend one to Charles and Nathaniel, it would be the Reckoners trilogy. It's basically post-apocalyptic Earth with people with superpowers taking over.
You guys have already been to my favorite place, and that's Paris. So I hope you guys had a good time and we'll be able to get back there very soon. Congratulations, guys.
We don't do it for the money. We don't do it for the fame. So all the critics who despise us, go ahead and criticize us. It's your tyranny that drives us as the fire to a flame. And it goes in one ear and right out the other. People talk the shit, but you know we'll never bother. It goes in one ear and right out the other. I'm only playing music because you know I'm fucking love it. It goes in one ear and right out the other. People talk the shit, but you know we'll never bother. It goes in one ear.